Hey everybody, welcome back to Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today we're going to be taking a look at a new feature in ChatGPT called GPTs. And GPTs are basically, they're pitched as apps for ChatGPT. They're more focused experiences around using the ChatGPT large language model. And I think they're really interesting. They're definitely not perfect, and they have some pretty big limitations that I find annoying. But I want to show you how they work today. I'm going to create one and kind of show you the whole process, which is not much. It's really pretty simple. So if you have used ChatGPT before, you can probably figure out how to use this. And it's really interesting. So we're going to walk through that. I'm going to show you another GPT that I made to help me with some YouTube stuff that I do on a regular basis. And yeah, we're going to kind of go through it and really look at what it can do for you, what's interesting, and how it's really limiting compared to where I think the end game is for products like this. So let's jump into it. Okay, and so just to level set what we're talking about, when I'm uploading a picture to social media, I could be like, great show last night, and I want to add a description describing the image so someone with a screen reader or someone who just can't see the image super clearly can know what's going on. They can hear or read what's going on in the image, which is helpful to everybody. But what we're going to show is how you can help do this with ChatGPT, and we're going to create a new GPT. You can actually see I've already created one called Alt Text Assistant, but I want to make another one just live here with you guys. I'm going to skip over some of the loading because this uses GPT-4, which takes a while to happen. So in the interest of time, we'll skip through some stuff. So you actually build it with plain text. You can actually go to this configure page once it's been going to kind of tweak things, but you just give it a prompt and tell it what you want it to do. So I've actually written it out already. Basically, I'm telling it to write alt text that's like very brief, 50 words or less. You can transcribe text to go over that if you need to. But yeah, don't add any extra text or color because ChatGPT likes to go on a little while. Just give me the text. That's it. So I'm going to send this message to the GPT builder, and it's going to start doing things. And I'll just fast forward through this so you can see what it generates just with that prompt alone. Okay, so the GPT behavior is updated, and so now it's responding. Now let's pick a name, and you can see over here on the right, we have some things that are generated. So creates concise alt text or images. Here's some conversation starters, and let's pick a name for it. How do you like clear caption creator? No, name it alt text bot. So again, just natural language, name it alt text bot. And so it's going to update it and in a second should reply and say, okay, I've done it, we've renamed it. And now it's generating a profile picture, right? So it wants to have kind of an icon here. While it's doing that, I can go to the configure page and you can see, the description, its instructions on what it does and some conversation starters. You can upload files. So if you have some alt text that you have done in the past, you could have it match that style. I've done this actually with YouTube. We'll show that in a second, giving it some titles I've used so it can suggest titles that are in my style. And then can this browse the web? Can it generate images? We actually don't need it to generate images, so we'll get rid of that. And okay, looks like it's actually created the things. So it's renamed it to alt text bot. And it's created this icon, and it's like, hey, do you like this? Do you want me to tweak it? You can tweak it. We're not going to do that now. Now, one thing for this specific use case, it can be helpful to do these conversation starters to like let someone click this to get the conversation going. With this sort of thing where I just wanted to do something based on an image, I'm actually going to delete all of these. I don't need any conversation starters, and you'll see why in a second. So let's just stick with this. I can change the image if I want. I can change the name, but I think it's in a good place. So let's go ahead and save it and say only people with a link can access it. So it'll give me a link to copy to the clipboard. I can make it public, which will show in the store, which is coming soon at some point, or it could be a private one just for you. So I'm going to do only people with a link so you guys can check it out. I'll put a link in the description if you want to try it yourself. So here we are in Alt Text Bot, and you can see it over here in the sidebar. And basically, to get my alt text, I can just drag this image in. I don't have to tell it anything, just hit enter. And now it's going to start processing the instructions that I gave it earlier and going to try to generate some alt text for me. So it's gone wrong. ChatGPT sometimes just breaks for whatever reason, which is annoying, but is what it is. So let's try it again. Should generate in a couple seconds here. And let me just check Mastodon. Yeah, so I've still got it. So I'll go to the description page again. And okay, so it's generating the stuff. A musician with long curly hair sings on stage with a backdrop featuring a pattern of skulls and strawberries. Silhouettes of raised hands from the audience are visible in the foreground, right? That's not the most amazing, but I could say, right, Ben Queller, sing on stage with a backdrop, right? And so that's reasonable alt text, right? So that's something I could do, and now I'm posting a better image to Mastodon with this. Now, elephant in the room, this is inconvenient. This is very inconvenient. It's inconvenient to be in one app, switch over, upload the same image again, get it, copy, and then paste over back to Mastodon. Understand, that's completely annoying and shouldn't be that way. Mastodon has this detect text from picture, so it can automatically pull text using OCR, but it doesn't do image description. So it'd be really great if there was a way to describe the photo from here. Or if I'm kind of just scrolling my feed and there's an image that doesn't have alt text. Let's see. A lot of these do. Here we go. This one doesn't have alt text. It would be great if I could have the app in real time generate alt text for me. So acknowledging that this is a kind of workaround, it's more of a proof of concept. I'm going to drag these other three images in here and show you kind of what it generates, but they're probably going to be pretty decent and can get you pretty darn close to what you need. Okay, so I'll show the results on screen so you can see kind of what things it generated for these images, but pretty good on the whole, right? Like, I'm pretty happy with how these turned out, and sure, you could tweak them a little bit to be a little bit more personal, a little bit more in your voice, but they're great starting points, and they're certainly better than nothing. So before we go, I did promise I would show you my YouTube helper, which I use to kind of like just do some of the publishing stuff that I don't love. Basically, whenever I record a video, I feed it into Mac Whisper, which creates this nice subtitles file for me, which gives me better than average subtitles on YouTube because they're better than YouTube's auto-generating ones. But basically what I can do is I can upload this to my YouTube helper and do things like create video titles, suggest a thumbnail, generate chapter times, those sorts of things. Now, one of the annoying things you're going to notice right away is when I upload this file and say create video titles for my transcript, these kind of conversation starters don't accept the file you uploaded. So it's going to complain every single time that, oh, I don't have a file. Can you give me a file to use? And so now you actually have to upload it. It'd be really nice if those conversations could accept the file that you uploaded down here. But now it's going to go through, I gave it some titles that I've used previously to kind of tune its suggestions to what I would generally write myself. And now it's going to suggest 10 titles for me. So here they are. And again, I tend not to use the exact title it gives me, but they're good inspiration to get an idea for what sort of title could work. And then I tweak it to my preferences. So yeah, again, if you have a ChatGPT Plus account, you can go to the Explore page. You can click the link in the description to get my alt text bot and try it out yourself if you want. I'll put the YouTube helper in there as well if you'd like. I'll make that public so you can check that out. And as of today, as of recording, which is Monday, November 13th, there are only made by OpenAI GPTs in the storefront. The store itself is coming at a later date. So maybe by the time this video is out, it'll even be available. But yeah, so there'll be hopefully some interesting stuff that people make there. But for now, you can check out what I've done and make your own if you have a ChatGPT Plus account. So thanks so much for watching. Bye-bye.